Hey, Summit Kids, we're on day 18 of our 21 days through Matthew. So if you want to turn with us, we're going to go to Matthew chapter 26, and we're going through verses 57 through 66. Okay. So last we heard they had Passover. Jesus went and prayed in the Garden of Gethsemane, and then he was arrested. Now, after his arrest, they put him on trial. And you guys remember the Pharisees. The Pharisees didn't like Jesus, right? Why didn't they like him? Well, he was preaching things that they didn't like. He was saying, I can forgive your sins. And they're like, only God can forgive sins, right? So he's putting himself on equal standing with God. And then he was healing people on the Sabbath when he shouldn't have been. He was doing different things that weren't bad things, but they were against the tradition that the Pharisees held. So they really didn't like him, and they wanted him arrested, and they wanted him to die, pretty much. They wanted to be gone with him. They wanted all of his power gone. So here we look at the trial with the high priest. So verse 57. Those who have arrested Jesus took him from Caiaphas, the high priest, in whose house the scribes and the elders had gathered, which they weren't even supposed to gather there, but he was a shady high priest. But Peter was following him at a distance as far as the courtyard of the high priest. And going inside, he sat with the guards in order to see how this would end. Now, the chief priests and the whole council were looking for false testimony against Jesus so they might put him to death. It was super common for them to give false testimony. They even had books that taught people how to give false testimony well. So then they were just waiting for false testimony. They're waiting for a testimony to come in. Lots of false testimonies came in. And then two people came in and they took Jesus's words out of context. And they said, this fellow said, I am able to destroy the temple of God and rebuild it in 3 days. They weren't really saying, he wasn't really saying destroy the temple and rebuild it. He was making a reference to when he would die and be buried for 3 days and raise again. And they didn't understand this. Remember how Jesus talked in parables and riddles and all this? So the Pharisees didn't understand, and they're coming forward and saying this, and they're like, look what he says. The high priest stood up and said, have you no answer? What is this that they testify against you? But Jesus was silent. He knew that he had to go through with this so that he could, you know, the forgiveness of sins could happen, that he would have to go through with dying and being resurrected and everything. So he was silent. Then the high priest said to him, I put you under oath before the living God. Tell us if you are the Messiah, the Son of God. And he's basically saying, are you this guy that we heard about back in Daniel? Are you the same Messiah that we've been waiting for? Of course, he already didn't think that Jesus was. Jesus said to him, you've said it so, aka, yeah, it's true. But I tell you, from now on, you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming on the clouds of heaven. Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, he has blasphemed. Why do we need witnesses? You have now heard this blasphemy. And it was common when there was blasphemy, when somebody would say something that would look negatively on God. So he's saying, basically, I'm at the same level as God. If he were to speak negatively against who God is, then that would be blasphemy. And that was common. It was like mandatory that they would tear their clothes, take their clothes and rip it. To me, it seems super dramatic, but I guess it was common. Then the high priest tore his clothes. What is your verdict? They answered. He deserves death. Then they spat in his face and struck him. And some slapped him, saying, prophesy to us, you Messiah. Who is it that struck you? You know, kind of taunting him. And remember, Peter is standing back. He's standing way far back, watching what would happen, watching the verdict. I want you to take out your journal and I want you to think about what it would have been like if you were a disciple and you were watching this happen. Go through each line, each verse. What would you be thinking? How would you be responding? Put yourself in the position of Peter in this text. Journal about it. All right, guys. Well, I'll see you tomorrow for day 19. Good morning, Summit Kids.